Hello and welcome to One Up Keyboards. No, wait. To what is this? Welcome to the live. Oh. And I screwed up the thing as it came in too. It went black for a second. It was close. Whatever. I tried. Live from New York. It's Saturday evening again. Welcome to Mechanical Keyboards Live. I'm your host, Skewed Pete. This is a bunch of stuff from One Up Keyboards. Well, some stuff from One Up Keyboards. This isn't on One Up Keyboards yet. For those of you who are new, thank you. Welcome. Don't forget to press subscribe. Don't forget to press like. Don't forget to do whatever else you're supposed to do. Remember, if you press like, it lets other people know that the content here is what it says that it is. And we're talking about mechanical keyboards, and these are mechanical keyboards. So, you know what I'm saying. Welcome to everybody who's already in the chat. Zombies, Mechanisk, I never know. Troy White, Mini Zeus, Felix Anderson, TIBGW2, yo, Alfonso, Zelazy, how you going? Oh, and Zelazy says, saw the clothing vid, nice work. I'm embarrassed about myself and the way I look, but I'm trying to get over it. That product is a neat product. Steph's taken advantage of it. The what's it called, Steph?
Stitch Fix.
Stitch Fix. Stitch Fix. Today, Stephanie has her own microphone, which is awesome. But she hasn't turned it on yet. She will though. She will shortly. Welcome to everybody again, especially those of you who are new. Don't forget to watch in 1080p. This is being streamed in extremely high quality. 1080p is awesome. And don't forget, I already said, don't forget to subscribe. Hopefully you're already subscribed. And don't forget to press like if you haven't already pressed like. What else am I supposed to say? Don't forget to say hello. Talk in the comments. I really do appreciate it. Johannes is here. Konas is here. Mechanisk is up in the house. I've already said hello. Blower355GR. That's a cool name. Ryan is here. Victor. Yo, Weekend Airsoft Warrior, what's going on, guys? Well, welcome to the show. I kind of threw this together at the last minute. I was talking to Leander, or Mechanisk, as he's now known in this channel. I was chatting to him, and he wanted a show, so I said, okay, fine, we'll do it. But I don't really know what I'm going to do. I kind of got a plan for one thing, and then I think we're going to talk about a couple other things, and then I might prep for a build for tomorrow. If you guys are around for that.
Or build in it.
David King, what's going on? Paolo Castro, yo, what's going on? Black Fatality, that's a cool name. Bass Booster, yo. So I don't know how much you guys all know about mechanical keyboards. So I'm gonna assume that everybody kind of knows what's going on. These are two kits that are available on 1UP Keyboards. This one is the carbon fiber kit. With JTK, white on black, WOBS. This key set is not available on 1UP Keyboards, but this side printed key set is. This is the same kit, but this one is made with stainless steel. And my God, it's heavy. I should do I'm going to do a weight comparison between those two, because this one's a beast. Let me just switch over to the action cam so you can see this one. This one actually has low profile standoffs, so it stands a little lower than this one does, about 2 millimeters. Those low profile standoffs will be coming to the store very soon, and if you don't already see them, you can just send us an email and ask for them. We'll totally hook you up. They're totally cool. These are the side printed keycaps. This is Cherry MX Browns. I built this in a live stream, what was that, last week? It's a nice keyboard. It's almost as nice as that one. But you know what? I want to grab the scale and just tell how different these two weigh. Oh, and the other thing is that I did this week is I installed a new selfie cam. I thought I installed. There's a new selfie cam. Yo, what's up? And there's Steph in the background. This is the sewing machine from 1UP Keyboards happening right here. Welcome. And what's even cooler, it almost looks like I'm looking at the camera because I've installed a new monitor, JB1830. I don't know if you're in the channel, but thank you very much for helping with that. Look, it's like I'm looking at you-ish. It's close enough. So there's that. Also, the overhead is now even more overhead than it's ever been before, which is great. I really do appreciate all the help with that. Foreman says, what's up? Felix, what's up? Guys, I'm just gonna grab the scale real quick and then we'll get going. And soon, if you guys start asking questions, Steph will actually turn her mic on. Even though when she turns it on, it's gonna make your ears pop, but whatever. Okay, starting off with the scale. Okay. This is in ounces, but how mode? I'm going to change it to grams. GN, is that grams? You'd think that GN would be, a G would be, there's grams. Okay. In grams, this weighs 400 grams. Wow, that's heavy. 400 grams, that's like a pound. That is a pound for the carbon fiber one. Now, what's this puppy come in at? Overload.
It's only a little scale. You need the bigger one.
Hold on. Maybe. What's GN?
It doesn't matter. It only has it. It still has a top weight, so you're over on the top weight.
Yeah, GN is something different. I don't even know what GN is. Okay, give me one sec. I'm gonna go get a different scale. Where's the other scale?
Over there.
Does this do grams?
Yes.
Grams, just to be in metric. Unit. Grams. You ready for this?
Do the other one first.
The other one first, in grams.
Just to make sure.
In grams. 425 grams. Okay, 454 is a pound. This is 424. Are we ready for this? I'm going to do it this way. 981 grams. That's over 2 pounds. This one's a... I don't know how it can only be weigh twice as many as this. This one feels light and like... This one feels... Whoa, my God. Okay. Okay, well, that was, for those of you who just joined, that was Weighing Keyboards with Ski with Pete. Okay, moving on to the next. I'm going to change some keycaps here.
Where is your set? Did you get it?
What? No, I didn't. Steph is pressurizing me to put Stormtrooper on, and I'm not quite ready to do that. I want to do this first. Let me do this and then we'll move on to that. So for those of you who are new to mechanical keyboards, there are different types of keycaps, and these represent the two different types of keycaps. These on the left are called PBT keycaps, and PBT keycaps are made with PBT plastic and they're quite thick. And they don't go shiny. What we have here, let me pull one off so you can take a look. These are actually, these are from a grab bag from Signature Plastics, and these are thin ABS. Maybe you can see that, maybe you can't. Emil says, sup, why are we weighing keyboards? The answer is I have no idea why I did that. I just thought, wow, that one was heavy. I should check out how much it weighs. Okay, so this is, look, that's thin PBT. That's what a thin one looks like. This is what a thick one looks like. Sorry, thin ABS, thick PBT. Now, ABS is a super strong plastic. It's really good quality, and it's what they use in Lego, so you know that it's really good. But PBT doesn't shine and has a better, rougher feel to it, and I think it's preferred in a lot of cases for keyboards. There are some exceptions. We'll talk about those exceptions later, but I'm just going to start pinging off these keycaps and replacing them with the PBT ones. I got these PBT ones from a Vortex set that I gave to my father-in-law this past week. These were running spare. He made a TKL, which I hope to share on the channel soon. And the only problem with that build, he made a soldering mistake, but we didn't film the repair, which is an oversight on our part. So this was, I made this in a live stream recently. These are Gattastuttles, and these are made by Creamy. They're a very clicky switch. Oh, that feels a ton better already. Oh, did I really do that? I don't know what the top row order is. Steph, can you look that up for me, please? I know that num goes there. And you start with the smalls on the bottom.
The way that you had it.
What's that?
Whatever it was, you had it right?
I had it right, I just don't know what it was.
Oh, I can pause it, go back and pause it. It was num block.
Yeah, num.
Plus.
Hold on. Num. Uh-oh. There's no plus. Num multiply?
No, this is the next one over.
Num multiply. Go on. Num what?
Minus.
Num minus?
No, num plus multiply minus. Oh, divide. Sorry.
What the hell? That was so weird. Steph.
I'm not paying attention. You didn't let me in my second coffee.
Okay. Seriously, Steph. Turn your mic on. This is insane. Mr. GJ says, does anyone know where I can find a mechanical keyboard? Yes. What sort of mechanical keyboard are you looking for? For beginner keyboards, I recommend on Amazon, there's a link in the About section, the QFR or Quickfire Rapid. It's a great keyboard. Okay, numlock, numlock, divide, multiply, minus. Yeah, that's what it is.
My apologies. And my microphone's on there, so I should be a little louder.
Oh, okay. So now you can hear Steph make mistakes in full volume. That's great. Zombies says, I'm a typist and currently using the K95 RGB with the MX red switches. I hate the linear switches on here, and I would like to get your opinion on this configuration I put together. Unfortunately, I can't click on that link right now, but maybe if Steph can click on it. You know what? I'm going to... Yeah, I just threw these back in a bag, but you know what? I'm going to put these back on my board. Neve, what's going on? The Razer Black Widow. So a lot of you returning viewers... Let me look.
You don't need the...
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I see the problem. Zombies, they don't actually work together. What you need is... What you've got there is the LJD 61 up, which is a plate combination as... you know what? Forget this. I'm going to show you exactly what I'm talking about. Okay, so look. There's the LJD 61 up, which is... Oh, I got to zoom out. Okay.
And just it.
Okay, look. This is the LJD 61 up. It's the top and bottom, and you put them together, and that makes your keyboard. The other option that you have is to go with a universal top plate, and then you combine that with a base like that silver base.
Which is that silver base?
Which is this silver base, like this. So you put this universal top with this. You see what I'm saying? Or you do this, right? Which is two things combined. Does that make sense? So in your cart, you had these two and this, which don't work together.
So you can do one or the...
So you can do one or the other. See what I'm saying? Okay, I'm gonna go back to the other thing I was doing. No problemo. Don't forget, guys. Press on that 1080p. Make sure you're watching this in full high-res beauty. Oh, I see why Steph thought it was a plus. It's not a plus. That was a divider sign.
I know.
I understand.
I was so zoomed out that I wasn't paying attention.
I thought you were just being crazy.
No, I just wasn't paying attention. Okay.
So a lot of guys are asking about popular keyboards that you can buy, say, at Best Buy, which is cool, and it's the way to get into this hobby for sure. But a lot of the stuff that I'm going to be talking about is more for the high-end keyboards.
And you might need to finish that. What would you recommend? Zombies is asking.
What would I recommend?
Or is it just an aesthetics thing between the two?
Yeah, it's just an aesthetics thing between the two.
One is closed and one is open, though. Like, one is a sandwich plate and one is...
Yeah, one's a sandwich, one is a universal top plate with a base. And it not only depends what look you want to go for, but it depends if you want to be able to swap your bases. So if you think, oh, maybe I'll get a silver one now, and later I'll get a blue one, or I'll get a green one, or whatever, that's the traditional, yeah, as Mechanisk has just said, that's like the traditional way to go. The other way you can go, of course, though, is with the sandwich look. And the sandwich look, it's unique, but it's not as easily transferable, if that makes sense. You go one way, and that's the only way you can go with it. This is an awesome... I wish I had more of these. They're so rare, and I bought like 10 of them off Mass Drop, and people, every time I talk to them, they want to trade me for these things. Do you know a $40 keyboard that's mechanical? I do know a $40 keyboard that's mechanical. If you check out on my channel, the first player mechanical keyboard review that I did, the first player Steampunk, I think it was called, that's $40 and it's mechanical. I don't know that I would necessarily recommend it. I think you might be better off saving your dollars and buying a Quickfire Rapid. It's only a few dollars more, but it is an option for sure.
And then a question from Zombies about the Topre switch.
I have Topre. I'm just going to switch over to my selfie cam for a quick second. This right here is Topre, the one that I'm using at the moment there. Can you hear it? No, because it's Topre. What were you asking about Topre?
Is it that much better than the Gateron Clears for typing?
Gateron Clears.
What's the difference?
Yeah, Topre is very different from Gateron Clears. Gateron Clears are a linear switch, and if you're already using a linear, they'll be similar, except they're very light. They're so light that, as I've said previously in my channel, if you just rest your thumb on the space bar, just like that, that's enough to activate the switch. So I bought a Razer Black Widow. Is there a way I can make a custom backlight? I don't know the answer. I don't know enough about Chokan, you can get mechs for $40. Like, it's not completely outside of reason, but yeah, you're gonna be getting a really low end one. The Steampunk that I reviewed recently, it had major flaws, and while the switches are mechanical indeed, you know. Cool. Moving on, I'm just going to go throw this away, and this rubber dome, it's not a rubber dome, it's a rubber eye. Those are good for silencing your keyboards, by the way. How expensive is a keyboard you recommend instead of a $40 mechanical keyboard? The QFR, or Quickfire Rapid, the Quickfire Rapid is $69 when it's on sale, I think. Benzible asks, am I a guy? Yes, I'm a guy. Just me, Dave, what's going on? Benzible, no, I am not. My wife is on the channel. Say hi, Steph.
Hi. You can hear me now. A bit better.
No, large. Oh, later on in the show, if we're so lucky, there will be pizza. I know you guys who are old school, who've been around here before, you know exactly how exciting that can be. There will be New York pizza.
With pepperoni.
So with pepperoni.
Quite, not quite.
And some bread rolls. It's pretty much delicious. So this numpad is called the CLZ. C is for creamy, L is for Leander, who's also known as Mechanitsky's in the channel. I keep pointing up here because that's where the monitor is for you guys that are in the channel. I'm trying to bend the monitor down. It's not really working. Maybe I can grab it and you guys can look at my
phone. Where were you in answering questions? So you've got, what is the best hybrid one can get?
The best hybrid? The Prius?
No, keyboard.
I don't know what a hybrid is.
Well, you're half mechanical.
Oh, half mechanical?
I would have assumed.
The best half mechanical you can get is not to get one.
And are there premium non-laptop chiclet switches?
What? Yes. Are there premium non-laptop chiclet switches? Yeah, you could get a Mac keyboard, but honestly, for the $80 to $100 that you'll spend on that, you'd be much better off with a mechanical keyboard. I know, because, and I'm not just kidding. I have a Mac keyboard, and it sucks. Look, I have one with ISO. Are you watching Mechanist? Look at this, ISO, man. Look at that, look at this. Hey, what do you think of that?
How hard is it to replace change LEDs that are inside the switches, located inside the switches?
Very difficult. So there could be two different types that you're talking about. If you're saying that they're inside the switches, are you saying the ones that are through the hole? So if you look at this switch here, let me zoom
and
you
in. And Just Me Dave is enjoying his MX Clears.
Oh yeah, cool.
In Fosen housing.
Okay, look, if we look at this, this is your thing. If you have the LED that's in here, though, it's easy to get it out. All you do is take the board apart, desolder it, and pull it straight out. If they're inside the switch, which sometimes they can be, like SMD done to the board, and then the switch on top, it's more difficult, but I'll assume that when you meant in switch, that that's what you meant.
Do you know of any decent hot swappable keyboards?
Decent hot swappable keyboards?
Yeah.
What's the name of the one that Glorious PC 60? Gamer?
Oh, I don't know. Is it?
Glorious PC Gamer has
hot
swappable keyboards. There's another one. It's not the White Fox, but it's got a foxy name, I think. True Fox or something. But I don't know. I'll be honest, I haven't used them. The switch that's in the numpad is the Gadistotle. It's the Aristotle switch.
RY025 said, hi, Pete. It's really cool you were just in Dallas. I live there.
Oh, awesome. Did you enjoy the daily vlog? I mean, the vlog that I did in a day.
From Dallas.
Gateron Blues are a little quieter than this. I've got a Gateron Blue right here. Here's some Gateron Blues right here. Yeah, Gateron switches with Aristotle stems. That's correct. So again, you know, I know some of you guys are going to be new to mechanical keyboards, and you might be buying your first mechanical keyboard maybe at a Best Buy or something. This conversation might be a little bit more advanced than that, but just to explain, what you can do is you can take each individual switch. Let me just grab a switch to show you. So you can take each individual switch, here's one here, and you can open it up and replace the pieces on the inside. So you can change the slider so it makes more noise or less noise. You can change the spring inside there so it, why don't I open one up? Why don't I open that up? Show you guys what I'm talking about.
He did enjoy your vloggy.
What's that?
He did enjoy your vloggy.
Oh, excellent. Thanks, man. Thanks. I did the vloggy, and then the next day woke up so sick. I intended to do another, like, two more vloggies the rest of the week, and I just never did
because
I
was too sick. That numpad programmable?
This numpad is programmable. And we hope to sell it on oneupkeyboards.com eventually soon, one day. For those of you who are just joining, don't forget to press like because the content is actually about mechanical keyboards. Don't forget to press subscribe if you haven't already. And don't forget to say hello in the chat. Really appreciate you guys weighing in on this stuff. Okay, I want to show, this is for the, not the noobs, but the noobs, the guys who are new here.
Well, we're learning.
Everybody who's still learning. You know what, I'm not going to do this camera. I'm going to do the overhead and I'm going to zoom in. Okay, yeah, I can zoom in more than this.
Ooh, okay. Don't do the rapid fire, quick fire rapid eye. Just do the quick fire rapid because then you can get a frosty flake and make it programmable.
Yeah, the frosty flake turns your keyboard into a programmable keyboard.
But if you have the QFR eye, it's not compatible with it. So you need the one without the eye.
Steph is talking absolute sense here. The keyboard in the thumbnail is called the LJD61 Up, and it's available from oneupkeyboards.com. And that's the black carbon fiber. Thomas, who asked. Okay. So let me, hello to everybody who's joining. There's a whole bunch of people saying hello, hello, hello. Nick and David and Oscar. And yeah, I totally appreciate it, guys. Late GT and Dracomir and everybody that I've missed and forgotten. But let's just talk about what you get when you get a switch. Here's a switch. And this is the base of the switch. These are the gold cross points. And the reason it's gold is that it doesn't corrode or wear. Okay? That used to be something that only came in Cherry switches, but now comes in other aftermarket switches. This base is black, and it's got four holes on the bottom. We'll talk about that later. This spring, this is a 35-gram spring because this is for the Gateron Clear. That spring goes in there like that. On top of that is the slider. This is the slider here. You can see the side of it, the profile of the slider, and the slide, this bit goes towards the gold contacts. You line that up like that. Then on top is the clear housing. Oh, sorry, there's the clear housing. And that goes this way around. And look, you can see there, as I've clipped it back together, that's it. That's all there is to a switch. So why do we on our website and on this channel and everywhere else use Gateron switches rather than Cherry switches? Cherries are much more popular, but Cherries have a scratchier feel. I think it's because of the type of plastic that's used in the slider. And so the slider on the Gaterons gives a much smoother actuation. And you can feel it when you're typing that it comes through smoother. So that smoother switch is the reason that a lot of enthusiasts go for the Gateron type of switch. You see it's also got the gold contacts, the same that Cherry does. So what are you losing by getting a Gateron and not a Cherry? Well, you're saving money because Gaterons are cheaper, and you're getting just about the same specs as you would with the Cherry. Now, the only difference comes when you're talking about Cherry MX Clear. Cherry MX Clear is a tactile switch. And you cannot get that same tactility in a Gateron. The only place you can get that is in a special switch called the Zelios. And the Zelios switch is a little bit different than this one. Maybe I'll just go grab one to show you. So this is a Zelios switch. The Zelios switch, it's a lot like a Gateron. It's made by Gateron, in fact. Oh, sorry, just making sure I got it. It's got a purple slider, and it's got a tactile bump to it. The springs come in 62, 65, 67, or 78 gram. And you can see the bottom of the housing is clear as well, so you can really see inside of that. You can see the little spring in there. It's a gold spring, again, so it doesn't corrode. And that is a little walk around of Gateron switches. Now, as an enthusiast myself, I used to have a lot of Cherry MX clears. I had a lot of Cherry MX switches in the end. But now, having gone through and made a lot of my own boards, I'm pretty much exclusively Gateron. Cool. So that's different types of switches. If you have any questions about those, you've got to...
No, we don't have mod switches.
No, we don't have mod switches in stock yet. We do have mod switches coming. Those are made by a different company, and while I've tested them, I can't really tell you a whole lot more about them. Actually, maybe I could pull one apart.
Gateron yellows are the same as Gateron blacks.
Gateron yellows and Gateron blacks are exactly the same, and they're smoother than cherries. So with cherries, you get a little scratchiness. With Gaterons, it's a much smoother actuation. It's very good.
I think I saw a question of what board do you use?
Would the 78 gram Zelios have more of a tactile bump than those with the weaker spring? Some people report that it feels like it does because the resistance builds up more, but I think that the actual switch, it looks the same. Why are my fingers so hairy? My fingers are hairy because I'm 38% Hobbit. No, 48%. I don't know. I'm a large part Hobbit. Yeah, go on.
What board do you use?
My daily board. I'd love to show it to you. It's the LJD 61 up.
Are the Zelios switches better tactility and less noise than Gateron Browns?
Are the what?
Zelios.
Are the Zelios more tactile? Yes. And less noisy? They're about the same noise level. The only noise that you hear is the clack as you bottom out at the bottom of the keyboard. So there's two different noises that you can get with a keyboard. You get the click and you get the clack. So with a blue, you get click and clack. With linears and tactile switches, you only get the clack.
And yeah, no thoughts on the mod switches yet.
No thoughts on them yet. One of them, feels like it has a really round, big bump in it.
It is actually the mod M he's asking after.
And it feels like the one that I'm going to like, but it's too early to tell. It's too early to tell. And I mean, yeah, if I were you, I would let some enthusiasts get hold of them, try them, and then you'll get there.
Zoro blues and Zoro purples?
I haven't tried any of the Zoros yet. Do you have a tip for a good gaming keyboard under $100 for FPS shooter? Yes, the QFR. Oh, as Mechanisk is writing, the Quickfire Rapid. That's the one to get. That is, if you don't have one yet, go into the About section below this channel, go click on the link for Amazon, and go get yourself a Quickfire Rapid. Quickfire Rapids, Steph uses one. Yeah. I mean, she's well into the keyboard world, and she uses one.
Okay, you have some arguments for the Gateron Yellow 55 gram and Gateron Black 60 gram, and then somebody else is saying, aren't Gateron Blacks heavier at the bottom and Yellows are uniform weight the whole way?
I don't know. Somebody needs to do some real science on that. As far as I can tell, they feel a lot the same.
Do you ever go to thrift stores and buy old used keyboards?
Yes, all the time. I'm a dumpster diver. I go looking for old used keyboards. I sold one recently. I think that the black is slightly stiffer here. But it's in my left hand.
Are you completely confused zombies now?
About what?
Gateron yellows isn't Zelios, right? Right.
Gateron yellows are not Zelios. Zelios are Zelios. Nothing else is a Zelio. Zelios are four weights of a tactile. They're cherry MX clears. Gateron clears are non-tactile. They're linears. That's the only bit that's confusing, I'd say.
And then, do you recommend Steel Series switches? Those are cherries, aren't they?
Steel Series switches.
Well, Trevor's keyboard.
Yeah, yeah. They typically use
a cherry switch.
They typically use cherry in their keyboards.
What are brown cherry switches?
What are brown cherry switches? They are a tactile cherry switch. Why are Zelios so expensive? Because they're made in limited numbers, and they're made by a fella called Zeal PC, based out of Canada, and he designed them and licenses that to Gateron, and he's the only person who sells them. So that's why they're more expensive, and why they're more difficult to get, and why you can only get them in limited numbers. You know, we had some this week, and we sold out of everything other than 65 grams at oneupkeyboards.com, and we're not going to be able to get more probably until the middle of the new year.
Is the carbon true carbon or just vinyl?
No, it's true carbon. They're actual carbon plates. And you know how you can tell? We found this out. It's super interesting. The way you can tell if it's real carbon fiber or not is if it's conductive. So let me show you exactly what I'm saying here. Which setting was it on?
Did you see it? The little
arrow guy, right?
Yeah.
Okay, watch this. So look. You can tell if something is conductive because...
You touch them two together. Oh,
yeah. Look, this desk is not conductive, but if you touch the two together, it's not conductive either. Wait, what?
What? Did you break it?
Did I break it? What?
You broke it.
How did I? But what? One sec. Let's do ohmic resistance. Then at least we know that it's going to work. Yeah, so the desk is conductive. These are conductive. But this plastic is not conductive. And the anodized aluminum is not conductive. But if we go over here to the keyboard, you see that it is conductive. Do you see that? That's because it's real carbon fiber. And that's...
No ETA on the Mod M switches yet. They're coming.
Neat, right? That's a neat way to test for real carbon fiber. Yeah, you got to understand 1UP Keyboards. We are obsessed with quality here. That's our whole thing. Whole thing.
Do the screw holes on the V60 PCB line up with those on the aluminum case from 1UP Keyboards?
Yes.
Excuse me, aluminium.
Yep. Yeah, that's true. Again, we're talking to two different layers here, guys. Just seeing some comments about it. If you're a noob and you want to get your first mechanical keyboard and you want to try it out, maybe try a couple different switches or something, the best way to do that, you can go onto 1UP Keyboards and buy a switch tester pack and try them all out. After that, you should go to Amazon and get the QFR, type on that for a while, and then once you're an enthusiast, once you're like trying more and more of these keyboards, that's when it's time to go get some Gaterons or some Zelios and really push the edges of this. You know, it's difficult for me to tell you as a beginner to like spend $350. Is it $350 for a board like this? It would be difficult, so I'm not sure I recommend it. If you're an enthusiast and you're getting into it and you're buying your second keyboard or your third keyboard, Now it's time. This is one hell of a board, this thing. It's why I use it every day. It's my personal fave. And it's community designed. This is designed by JD of JD Carpe, JD, the guy who designed the JD 40.
Yeah. sorry. Did you what type? What keyboard is that, and how much is it?
Which keyboard is what?
You answered that already, didn't you?
I think so. Is it 300? It's not really
$350. Well, it depends on which switches you decide.
You got to get the switches. You got to get keycaps. You got to get the board. You probably want the PCB. You got to get the standoffs. You probably want to get the feet. It's probably not $350. It's probably a little less than that, but.
You can go over to oneupkeyboards.com and.
Yeah, that's where you check. Oneupkeyboards.com. That's
the
place.
Put in all the options that you want, and then you can figure out how much it.
Is your mic on?
It should be.
Okay, so I don't need to repeat the stuff you're saying then. Cool. Don't forget, guys, we're broadcasting in 1080p, so make sure you use the higher resolution so you can check this channel out the way it's meant to look.
Don't you miss the errors on those 60% keyboards?
No. So on the 60% keyboards, they're fully programmable. So what I've done is I've bind them to a layer. Now, I actually have it as layer 2, and I can access layer 2 in two different ways. This is layer 2, but this is also layer 2. The reason this is layer 2 for me is that I don't usually use caps lock. So I can get to caps lock. I just need to do layer 2, layer 3, then press that, and it's caps lock. But whatever. This is my layer 2. When I access layer 2, or press this to access layer 2, when I press it, WASD becomes my arrow keys. So that, I'm now doing my arrow keys. Or sometimes I do this, and I'm doing my arrow keys. So, you know, you're typing. And then I use my arrows to go back, or sometimes I do, you can't really see it here with my pinky. Maybe if I switch cameras, no, you can't really, but I press both the shift and the caps at the same time to use the shift, you know, so you can select stuff with the arrow keys. So to me, this is actually, you know, this is faster than reaching over here for arrow keys, but sometimes I still do, which is why this is also my layer 2. Just because my brain isn't fully trained. You want me to type a bunch here? You ready?
Okay, now type on the blues.
Now, gotta run blues. How is that more productive? John, how is what more productive? Just I don't have to move my hands as much. Is that what you're saying? How is this? Okay. I'm going to select this row. Right? Now I've selected it. Okay, now I'm going to do it the other way. I'm going to go over here, and I'm going to press shift, and I'm going to do this. And then I'm going to do this. Yeah? Does that make sense? Hope that all makes sense. Oh, guys, I just saw somebody mention the word solder, and I've just got to show you my solder can, because it's crazy now. You ready? You guys ready for this? Solder can, just for 1 second. Just, oh my God, look at it. What? Oh my God. It's crazy now. Okay, sorry. I just wanted to do that. Which feel better in your opinion, cherry or Gateron blues? Gateron. Which sounds better, Gateron or Gattistottles? Gattistottles. But again, I know that part of my audience here is like, I'm not going to spend $2 per switch, but listen to this. I mean, my God. My God. What are the coins on the table? Oh, the reason there's coins on the table is that I hot glue those. Like, I got a hot glue gun, and it constantly tips over because it was too weighty. So I hot glue coins to the bottom of it, And every time I come home with a cup. Well, yeah, which sometimes helps. But when I come home and I've got a change in my pocket, I leave it over there so that I remember that in future videos I'm going to put more. And the best part is, it only costs a few cents. Greetings from Hungary. Hey, what's going on?
Have you tried Zeliostottles?
Zeliostottles, I have not, but I keep hearing about it. I have a screenshot of Quake MZ talking about the difference between Gateron yellows and Gateron blacks. Mechanisk has it. Okay, so you're saying that there's a difference, and that I should know what it is, and I don't. To me, blacks and yellows are identical.
Their Gateron blues are on that blue one.
The Gateron blues are on this. What are my favorite switch? Zeliostottles. Which weight of Zeliostottles? I don't know the answer. I have a blue keyboard at work that has 67 grams, and I've lent it to a friend at work. And I have 62 grams on here. And like the 67 grams, every time I touch it, I'm like, oh, they're so stiff. And the 62 grams, every time I get angry and I'm like, I'm going to write an angry email, I'm like, oh man, they're too soft. So I'm going to try 65 grams. And that's what we're going to talk about what keyboard I'm going to make tomorrow in tomorrow's video. But for right now,
Can you open up an MX Blue for us?
Can I open up an MX Blue for us?
You'd have to pull one out of... Oh, do you have one?
Cherry MX Blue. Bang! Like, I just happen to have one lying around. Sure. Cherry MX Blue, and should we open up a Gateron Blue just while we're here? Just to make it extra fun and simple?
What is your opinion on mechanical
keyboards? Bang! I happen to have one there.
Keyboards.
You know what else I happen to have? What's my opinion on what?
Mechanical Bluetooth keyboards.
Yeah, cool. I'm going to review one in a couple of weeks. I have one being sent to me. And I hear that it has a problem. Not all of them do, but I hear that this one in particular has a problem with keeping up to the number of characters. If you type over 70 characters per minute, then it loses Bluetooth connectivity. Now, that sounds terrible. That sounds like the worst thing ever. But I think they're sending it to me because I've admitted on my channel before that I can't type that fast. I don't know. I can't say for sure. But look, here we go. Let's get into these puppies. So you wanted to see a Cherry MX Blue. Let's do that. And a Gateron Blue. Oh, wrong. Wrong ones.
At Ski with Pete, I'm searching for a new mechanical gaming keyboard which is not so loud. Which can you recommend to me?
A new gaming keyboard which is not so loud? Get any keyboard except blues or greens, and then get the dampening O-rings from mechanicalkeyboards.com or braces elastics from eBay. Now, I just saw somebody say, I can only use the left half of my keyboard because I'm handicapped, but I want to use mechanical keys. Do you have any ideas? Yeah, what you should do is get a programmable keyboard like this, and then what you can do, if you can use your thumb, for example, you could have the board mirror itself. So when you hold down the space bar, then it would these would be reversed, and if you just tap the space bar, then it'll give you a space. So, for example, a G, and this one is H, so let's do G, and then if you pressed and held spacebar, then that would be H, or if you tapped it, then that would be a space. That's a great way to do it. Cool. Let's zoom in a little bit here. Have I ever tried Cherry MX Green? I certainly have. I really like them. I like Cherry MX Green because they click, but I don't necessarily bottom out, so I don't get the clack, which I quite like. So Cherry MX Blue, here we go. So the Cherry MX Blue is an all black housing, or at least the one that I have. You can get them with different housings. There we go. Open it up. And there you can see The Blue Spring. The Blue Spring is a, off the top of my head, a 45 gram spring, but somebody will probably correct me if I'm wrong. There you have the Magic Bean, which is what does the jumping. Yeah, there it is. You see that? And that's what makes the noise. And then you have the switch top. So there you go. Now, let's just look at a Gateron Blue. Don't forget, guys, for those of you who are here, please press like. Please press subscribe if you haven't already pressed subscribe. I've got a little trick, and I'll show you afterwards how to make sure your subscription works correctly. The one on the left is a Gateron. The one on the right is a Cherry. Oh, it's gone a little bit fuzz. Can you tell the difference? Well, you can see that this little leg here is a little bit thicker on this. It's also a little bit longer on the Cherry than it is on the Gateron.
Are the Zelio switches really worth the money over the Gateron Browns for a typist? Ask Zombies.
You know, it depends. Are you making your end game board? Are you making a board that you're gonna like love and use for years? Because if you are, yeah. If you're like, I'm still experimenting and figuring out which switch I'm gonna like, and I kind of budget conscious, then just get Browns. Like, just get Browns. Try it. Build your first board. Then you're not worried about it, and then you can buy Zelios at a later date. I mean, Zelios, yeah, they're way better, but are they worth it? They're only worth it if this is, like, really your thing, you know? So I lent my 67-gram Zelios to a guy at work, and, you know, he loves them, but I know that the money is going to kill him. Hey, wait, I'm going to go back in. Zoom. You ready? You're about to see how a Cherry MX Blue works. You ready? Can you see that? You get it? It sits at this height. You push it. All of a sudden, it engages and it pushes it down. Right? And you can hear it too. I'm going to move it. Oh, no, I can't. We're going to move it closer to the microphone, but then you won't be able to see it. Ready? You get it? So that is a Cherry MX Blue. That's how it works inside of its housing. What is this? Uh-oh. This is a mechanical keyboard show. Please don't forget to press like because it is about mechanical keyboards. So Cherry MX Blues are a very popular switch. When we went to Maker Faire as 1UP Keyboards, we brought the MX Blues with us on this keyboard. And as soon as people touch them, as soon as people do this, they say, oh yeah, it's just like the old IBMs. And for a lot of people, that was really cool. That was a really positive experience, and they wanted to get back into it. Now, I personally work in an office, so Cherry MX Blues are not really a possibility for me. But I think if you don't work in an office, if you got your keyboard in a room all by itself, I think Cherry MX Blues are a great place to be.
plans for a 96 key layout?
Me personally, no. I stick with the 60%. Oh, you mean on the website? No, not really, really. But maybe, maybe.
Invisibility says Key Clack will have one soon.
Yeah, we're working on an 87. Did I just say too much, Steph? You know what? I pulled this out of the new pile, but I've just scorched that corner a little bit. A little too strong on it, so it's going to have to go back up here. Oh, and of course, I've got one of the milk housings as well. The milk housings are just exactly the same. They're just milk. They're just milky in color. But exactly the same inside. All right, here, I'll zoom in. Yeah, the Cherry MX Blues have a... There you go. Again, same thing. Cherry MX Blues, the tactile feel is closer to the Cherry MX, to the Cherry MX Clears or to the Zelios than it is to, say, the Browns. The Browns' tactility is much smaller. Is 60% really that good? Yes. Yeah, so the PCB that comes with, well, it doesn't come with, you have to buy it separately, but as an add-on rather, that comes with these 60% is the Satin, and the Satin has 12 programmable layers. Is that right? No, 9 layers, 12 macros. So you can go down in layers. So for example, my F row key is this, like this. And then I can go down another layer, and that becomes my higher F keys. That becomes F11, 12, 13, 14, and through. And then, of course, it's got macros. So what I can do is press this and then press F. I don't know why I said F. I can do this and then press H, and that'll spit out an HTML page for me. What switches would you use for programming, MX Brown or MX Silent? It depends if you want tactile or if you want linear. MX Silent is a red switch that just has a cushiony bottom. So instead of hammering the bottom like that, you'll be hitting a sponge there. Honestly, the additional cost of the MX Silent, I would just get MX Reds and then get some of those dental bands or braces bands. You can get them on eBay. They're super cheap. Or you can get the proper ones, which are really nice, off mechanicalkeyboards.com. Mechanicalkeyboards.com, by the way, they're great people over there. Really, I know I've got my own company. We're oneupkeyboards.com, and we're really proud of everything that we do. But I've no shame at all in pumping mechanicalkeyboards.com. They're great people over there. Mechanisk.co, he's basically our partner over in Europe. There's other great companies in the space too. Originative has been a great partner for us, and we're definitely proud of being a member of the community. Controlall.io, they're nice people over there too. You know, just so many nice things to say about the people who work in this community. And Steph has just turned off her microphone, if you were wondering what that giant thing was. I need a gaming keyboard, and I'm deciding between the Corsair K65 or the Logitech G410. Which one should I get? You should get neither. You should get the Quickfire Rapid. I know, I'm just like a broken record, but the reason you shouldn't get the K65, which is the one out of the two of those you should get, the reason you shouldn't get the K65 is it has a non-standard bottom row. So the bottom row, look, this is what a standard bottom row looks like. 1.25, 1.25, 1.25, 6.25, 1.25, 1.25, 1.25, 1.25. That is a standard bottom row. Now go look at the K65. You ordered the Quick Fire TK Red Switches. Is it good for gaming? It'll be great for gaming. You're going to have a great one. But so you know, the Quick Fire TK, what I've just said about the standard bottom row, the Quick Fire TK does not have a standard bottom row. Jeff Bolton says, do you lube your switches? And if so, which lube do I use? I bought this stuff off Amazon. Crytox 205. I'm trying to find it. Here it is. I bought this stuff. Look at my hairy arm. Look how hairy my arm is. And there it is. GPL 205 Crytox. This is the stuff I use. There's also a thin lube called 105. I don't use the 105. I haven't yet. I mean, I have some, I just haven't used it. And you use thick lube on tactile, you use thin lube on linears. At least, I think so. I don't really know. Is a good mechanical keyboard the Drevo 71? I hope to have the Drevo 71 sent to me for testing. I will let you know. I don't actually know the answer, and I can't give you a report on it until afterwards. Can you show us the right black one? The right black one? Can you talk about the mechanic of Logitech keyboards? No, I can't. I'm not knowledgeable enough about Logitech keyboards to really give an honest answer about that. I've been playing with this blue switch. But I'm going to go put it back now. Guys, I'm going to show you how to press subscribe and to make sure that you're invited to the next live stream. And in the next live stream, I'm going to be building a mechanical keyboard, which I did in a previous live stream, but that's also what I'm going to do. I plan to do it tomorrow. I'll do a vote about it in just a few minutes, but let me just first click on the thing to show you how to subscribe. Okay guys, here's how you subscribe and catch all the live streams. First, click subscribe, like you normally would, then click the gear beside it. Now you'll see the notification menu. Click send me all notifications for this channel. That means that next time I start my live stream, you'll get a notification to let you know it's about to start. Did that make sense? Hopefully that made sense. That way you guys will get a notification just before the channel goes into live stream mode. Okay, we're going to talk about tomorrow's keyboard build. Because my plan is, barring getting called into work, I'm going to build a mechanical keyboard. Okay, so here are my choices. First up, the LJD 61 Up. This is in silver carbon fiber. You can imagine it like that. That's option number one. Option number two is this, which is the silver carbon fiber universal top plate. And I'm going to pair that with one of the silver aluminum bases from 1UP Keyboards. Or the third option is to build an LJD 61 Up in the limited edition red carbon fiber. And like I say, my plan is to do this tomorrow. So hopefully you guys will be able to tune in for that. Let me just show you, all three of these need the same things. So I'm gonna need this, a PCB, or at least I'm gonna need a PCB for this one. These two I could hand wire, but that's quite an operation, and I think I'm just gonna go with a PCB. So all three of these need a PCB. And besides that, they need stabilizers. Let me see if I can find a stabilizer pack. Do we have a stabilizer pack to hand, Steph?
Yeah, they're in
the
drawers.
Oh, okay.
Bottom row, or second bottom row.
So this is a PCB mount stab kit. They're different stab kits. stab stabilizers that go with each of these. So you need to get a stab kit. And then on top of that, you also need to get switches. And this is what a bucket of switches looks like. Okay, so 1, 2, and 3. It looks like everybody's voting 3 here. Is that what's happening? Sorry, I walked away for a second.
I'm not here. What's number 3?
What the red limited edition. I walked away, guys. I can't. Okay, let me scroll back up and see. Red one, second one, second one, one, three, 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 one, three, three, three. Okay, a lot of threes. I understand. So that's what you need to get. And then of course, if you want keycaps, and I'll just show you what the 1172. What? There's a lot of threes. I don't know, guys. This is craziness. And then of course, there's side printed keycaps, and I think. If I did the red one, I would do these white side printed. I think so. There's also black side printed. You see this side printed? Well, whichever one I'm build, I'm actually going to put for sale on oneupkeyboards.com afterwards. So it's just a matter. It sounds like it's going to be number 3, though. This will be a fun build. This in red. It'll be really fun. And, of course, you can get your own on 1UP Keyboards. I'm going to put this back. I'm not going to need that. What are your thoughts on Kyle switches? Are they as cheap as some say? They are not as nice as they are not as nice as some of the other switches. I'll be honest. I did actually build an LJD 61 up in a previous stream, but hey, I'll build another one. That's okay. I got a bunch to build. So K65 or G410? You would go with a K65. I would. What was the name that I recommended? It was the Cooler Master Storm Rapid, not the Rapid Minus I. Hands, if you're catching me, it's just the QFR Rapid. The Minus I has the lights, but the lights means that you can't upgrade with the Frosty Flake later. Pete, do you plan on having purple JD40 kits? Yes, Teddy, soon. Soon, my man. I think December 15th is the first possible date, but any delay in shipping will put us into the new year. What is your opinion on the Moto Speed CK104? I'm not aware of that one, actually. What do I think about the Poker 3? Poker 3 is a great keyboard. It's called Layer Programmable. If you go check out my video about the Poker 2, the Poker 3 is just an upgraded version of that. Given where I am in my own progression amongst keyboards, I no longer have any pokers because I go with fully programmable boards like this PCB here, but that's just a progression. If you're thinking about getting your first 60%, everybody gets the Poker 3, get the Poker 3, man. In your previous stream, you built a keyboard with black keys and a silver base. Could you please show it?
Yeah, sure.
This is the one that I built in my last stream, right here. So the people have spoken. The people of Despraca.
You're doing red.
I'm doing red. I don't know where this goes.
Have they decided which keycaps, black or red, or black or white?
No, but we'll decide that tomorrow in the stream. Have you ever heard of or tried TCC brown switches? They're very rare. No, I have not, Stream Cheese. Which is one of the cheapest mechanical keyboards? The QFR Quickfire Rapid. Maybe I should just put it on the sticky. Maybe I should.
Starter board.
It's the best starter board. It's the cheapest. It's the best cheap one.
Can be modified.
can be modified easily. I think that there's a link in the About section. In the About section below, if you go down there, you can see it. Do you know if the Frosty Flake works with the Quickfire Stealth? Yes. The Quickfire Stealth is the Quickfire Rapid, but with side-printed keycaps. So, yes, it does, and yes. What's a good keyboard TKL for programming on a Mac? Can you wait 6 weeks, man? Can you just wait a few weeks? Because we're going to release a TKL in a few weeks. Do you have a JD40 on hand? Of course I have a JD40 on hand. What the hell is this? Which JD40 do you want on hand? This is the original JD40. This was made by ControlAlt.io. And this is number 21 of 100. And I also have... I just dropped a keyboard, guys.
Oh, it's your
HHKB. Oh, I see HHKB. It'll survive. This is the other one. This is the 1UP Keyboards JD40. I know I'm skipping around a little bit, but this LJD 61UP is going to go on sale on the website. Not today, but soon. And it's because of the camera lens that it looks warped. In real life, it's not warped. IRL, it's... straight as you like. But camera lens, look at it bend. The cool ES87 is a solid TKL. It is. Which is louder, blue or green? I don't know. Excuse Pete, what are Frosty Flakes? Great question. Let me show you. So these are the JD40s. I'm just going to do this real quick. This has Cherry MX Clear switches, and this was built by my friend Margot Baggins. And this has Gateron Clears, which are very light, and this was built by me in a live stream. Any other questions about the JD40s? Opinion on a cheap $40 keyboard. You know, you're the second person today to ask about $40 keyboards, and my opinion really is save up the extra $30 and get a Quickfire Rapid. What do you think about hybrid capacitive switches? You mean tope rays? I'm not that into tope rays, even though I'm using them right now. Francesco Silvetti says, hi, I'm new to your channel. Can you do a tutorial on how to do a keyboard like those you are showing? Yes, tomorrow, if you tune in tomorrow, I'm going to build one of these. So press subscribe. And come back tomorrow around 2 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Steph's just trying to open up one of these Frosty Flakes here to show off. Yeah, I have both the answers though. This is the Frosty Flake. So the Frosty Flake is a replacement PCB for the Quickfire Rapid. So give me just 1 second.
Controller.
Give me 1 second. I'm just going to unplug Steph's keyboard.
Mm-hmm.
So this is Steph's keyboard here. I'm just going to zoom out so you can see it. This is Steph's keyboard. This, again, we're keyboard enthusiasts, we're nuts. And a CM Storm Quickfire Rapid. So when you open up this case, under here is a controller. And what you do, you wedge this out and then put this one in. No soldering required, it's just a push. You just pull it out and push it in. And actually, if you do a search on YouTube for the Frosty Flake, or for the Quickfire Rapid, you'll see my video where I do that. All you do, it's really not hard, you just wedge something in here. I'll use a guitar pick. You just wedge it in, open it up. You've got to open the void sticker. And once you've gotten inside, it's as simple as popping it up and pushing it down. You can buy these Frosty Flakes on 1UPKeyboards.com, and we ship around the world. For those of you just tuning in who don't know Yes, I am part of OneUpKeyboards.com. That's why I keep pumping it all the time. But it's also a pretty cool keyboard store you can ask other people. When is Steph going to have that whole keyboard filled with artisans? She's working on it. I say she's working on it. There's a major change coming to Steph's keyboard. But you'll have to tune in. When? Not next weekend. The weekend after that? Just before the weekend before Christmas, right? As soon as the Gattastottles come into stock,
I'm actually going to do a build.
Steph's going to build her own board. Cool. So what does the Frosty Flake do? The Frosty Flake turns a dumb keyboard like the QFR into a fully programmable, multi-layered keyboard like I've been building and showing off over here. So what that means is you can make it layer programmable. You can put layers in so that, you know, a certain combination makes an unusual character that you want. But it also does macros, and you can have up to, I think it's 12 macros. And each macro can be an A4 or 8.5 by 11 page fully typed out. So it's a pretty big macro. Now, Steph uses macros all the time. That's how she does a lot of, you know, I don't want to say answering emails. It's a lot of, like, order processing.
The orders, yeah.
Order processing. So she uses that to quickly punch through it. So, you know, quick commands are like change browser, put those things in. Where did we get those arrow keys? Those arrow keys that look like PlayStation are from techkeys.us. I didn't call them out earlier. I'm really happy to be part of this community and really happy to be one of the stores in the community. OneUpKeyboards.com isn't the only store. And techkeys.us, the guy over there, his name's Brad. He's a super nice dude. Philip Paris, where do you get it? You get it at OneUpKeyboards.com. Do I have a... Put a .com at the end of that. Hey, can you make a 100% macro programmable keyboard? I program a lot and would like to write words with just a single key. All of the keyboards here are programmable. And if you get a QFR, Quickfire Rapid from Cooler Master, you can use the Frosty Flake. Again, it's the QFR, not the QFRI. And it's not the only keyboard. The other keyboards, for example, you could use this thing called, can you see that? The Pegasus Hoof. That turns Philcos into fully programmable keyboards. Again, have a look on oneupkeyboards.com and you'll be able to see what different keyboards and what different models you can make fully programmable. You could do 104 key. For example, the Cooler Master XT is a full-size keyboard that you can make fully programmable, which is cool. Cool, okay, let me put some of these keyboards away and maybe I'll pull out some other ones and show off some different stuff. On oneupkeyboards.com, you know, we just this weekend released the GMK Stormtrooper, which is a limited edition key set. 150 sets were made. We had 11 of them and we have exactly one left. There should be a link to that in the About section below. If you go below this video, you should... I think there's a link to it. On Amazon, is there?
No.
Steph, can you post a link? I can post a link. Will installing a Frosty Flake void my warranty? Yes. Yep, it will. And if you don't install it correctly, it'll burn your keyboard. But as long as you line the pins up, it'll work fine. No link. Okay,
I'm getting one.
Steph's getting one.
My computer's really slow.
I'm gonna get one.
Everybody's just going a little too slow for me. Here, I can do it super fast.
You can do better.
Yeah, Cherry MX Blue right now is $72. $72, guys. Like, I know people are asking about yeah, I gotta agree with Mechanisk. If you're gonna go with it, do it. Do that one. What I'm gonna do, guys, and it's gonna take me a second. I'm just going to make sure that that QFR link is right up top.
A new and mechanical keyboards, are the keycaps universal?
No, the key, it's a tricky little, that's a great question and it's tricky. Give me just 1 second and let me get some keyboards out to show you.
What's a good 60% I can build on my own that's fully programmable?
The LJD 61 Up. Don't be crazy. Go to oneupkeyboards.com. Go check out the LJD 61 Up. It's a 60% board. Here's two of them right here. Look at how beautiful they turn out. This one is the carbon fiber. This is the stainless steel. This one we found out weighs a kilo. This one weighs just under a pound. Okay. I wanted to show you guys this. So just give me 1 second here.
Would that still be fine?
No, the Rapid Eye is not a fully programmable.
It's still better than the K65.
Still better than the K65, but you won't be able to make it fully programmable. Okay, somebody asked about keycaps and whether the keycaps are universal. And I wanted to tell you that there's something called the standard. The standard bottom row looks like this. The standard looks like that, these three 1.25s, a 6.25, and then four 1.25s. Do you see? Three 1.25s, 6.25, four 1.25s. Same again there, but watch. You can get variations on that, like this, where you get 1.25s, you get a 6U spacebar, a small spacebar, and then three 1.25s, and then the arrow keys are over here. And look, it's crushed the shift key. So there are different keyboards using different sizes. And just be aware of this bottom row. If you find a bottom row that looks like this, like you would on the QFR Rapid, Quickfire Rapid, or you know, a lot of other boards have this standard bottom row, then you'll find that a lot of keycaps will fit it. Most keycaps will fit this standard bottom row. If you start leaving this standard bottom row, things start to get a little bit tricky and you're going to have to be more conscious when you go out. It's not to say that things won't fit, it's just that you need to be more conscious. Yeah, no F keys, no numpad because they're all programmable. You see, with me, this enters a programmable layer and that turns these into F keys. So that's F1, that's F8. It's not that hard to figure out, is it? And then what I do for my arrow keys is WASD when I'm holding down my function layer. So yeah, it has no arrow keys and no F keys, but it does. It just means that it's extra small and extra portable. See what I'm saying? And super light. Cool. And then these keys up top here, these are called artisans. For those of you new to the community, these are artisans. They're released by artists.
Which standoffs do you use with the keyboard on the top?
Which standoffs? So you're saying those ones? These are the, I think these are called stainless steel?
What? No.
What are those called?
They're the threaded ones. They're silver brass.
Silver brass.
Or brass silver, whichever.
Brass silver. Is. They're the ones with the little pinstripes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's a brass, silver brass.
Silver brass. Is there a downside to having a non-soldered USB cable? In fact, I recommend it. You're talking about the non-solder kits? The non-solder kits are actually better. They're better. Don't tell people I said that. But they're stronger. They're stronger, man. I mean, I like making the odd solder one because then you can tell people that you soldered it yourself and they're like, what? You can do that? And you're like, yeah, man, it's super cool. And you can solder the little pieces and... But the clip-together ones are better. They're easier. They're easier. They're stronger. I don't know. I'm looking to build a white keyboard with Gateron reds. Any good set of keycaps that are blue? You know which ones I really like at the moment? White and blue keycaps are the Vortex ones that are available on mechanicalkeyboards.com. I'm a big fan of those. They're actually pretty cool. And the guys who run mechanicalkeyboards.com, they're cool as hell. So what should I do? If I should not get the Rapid Eye and not the K65, I mean the QFR is not available, what should I get? Well, if your budget is unlimited and you're still thinking of getting a TKL layout, then the next one I would recommend, and I say the budget is unlimited because I don't know how much it's going to cost in your area, I would get the Philco Magis Touch 2. Let me pull out my Philco Magis Touch. Just so you can take a look at it.
And Zombies is asking, what PCB and legs are on that keyboard?
What PCB is the Satan PCB, and the legs on this are the...
Gone matte silver.
Mm. Is your microphone on?
No.
Can you turn your microphone on? So I would... The next one up is this one. That I would get. Although you'll probably get the black one, not the white one, because these are limited edition. And these keycaps are also limited edition. This board that you're looking at here would probably cost you upwards of $400 in the configuration that I've got. But you can buy these off the shelf for about $120. Philco Magis Touch. The difference between this and the QFR, this has a fixed cable, whereas the QFR has a removable cable. But this fixed cable, it's quite nice. This one in particular comes with Cherry MX Blacks. Again, same thing. It has the removable, but instead of a Frosty Flake, this one is called a Pegasus Hoof. This is Triumph Adler Zambuman. This is a beautiful keyboard, if I'm honest. This is, about as beautiful as a mass-produced keyboard you're going to find. It is absolutely stunning. And then these keycaps on it, these are the Triumph Adler keycaps from GMK. These are like a rare community-built set by a long-standing community member who's less and less involved these days, called Intelli78. He's a really nice guy. He used to run KeyChatter. Let Split PCBs are out, $10 for a set. What's your take on them? I really like Let Split PCB. I'm friends with Max, or Woot Patoot. I think he's a really nice guy. I think he's got a really great idea. We're hoping The White Magic Touch 2 is on MK.com. MechanicalKeyboards.com actually has this.
Cool.
Ooh, you should probably get one. The Let's Split, going back to Max, he's a great guy. We're trying to get them onto 1UpKeyboards.com. Are Black terrible for typing? They're not terrible for typing. They're not my favorite for typing.
I think they work better for us if you've got a firmer...
If you're
like,
a,
if you bash type like a little bit more,
if you type like this, then they're fine.
I find them a bit tough. I like lighter switches.
Hands, yes, exactly what you just said. What do I need programmable keys for? If it's only meant for gaming, the Magis Touch is too expensive. Couldn't I get the Rapid Eye if I only want to use it for gaming? Yes, you should, and you should get the Rapid Eye over the other ones because it has the standard layout. That means you can get other keycaps for it in the future. I highly recommend that you do that. Highly recommend. Yes, get the Rapid Eye. The Rapid Eye comes with lighting, which for gaming you might find useful. That is totally the way I would go. Can you show us a gaming keyboard? I am showing you the gaming keyboard. Okay, the reason this is a gaming keyboard is that this uses Cherry MX Blacks. Cherry MX Blacks means that the spring is stronger, so it springs back faster, so you get that actuation, more APMs. More APMs means better gaming. Cherry MX Blacks, or if you're doing a custom, get Gateron Yellows or Gateron Blacks. The stronger the spring, the faster the bounce back, the more APMs. Bang! That is money for your money.
Zombies, send me an email at oneupkeyboards@gmail.com. And I can let you know. Let me know which LJD 60 went up with all the bits that you want, and I'll give you a quote for shipping.
Cool. I am desperate for some water or something. Can I have maybe a soft drink or something? Can you show us a Romer G? Unfortunately, I don't have any Romer Gs. Can someone send me a link for a really good mechanical keyboard, gaming keyboard for under $90? Yes. You ready? I'm sending it. Oh no. Oh no, my link is gone. Hold on. It's right here. Oh no, it's because my keyboard's not plugged in. Ha! I unplugged my keyboard for you guys. There you go. The best gaming keyboard right there. Bang. How do I know if my keyboard has a standard layout? It'll look like this. Look, 1.25, 1.25, 1.25. They'll all be the same size. This space bar is called 6.25. And then 1.25, 1.25, 1.25, 1.25. And how will you know? Because these four will be the same as these three. Your shift key will be full. There won't be anything interrupting it on either side. And you don't have something over here called a different sort of slash. The first thing that comes off of shift is a Z or a Z, depending on where you are in the world. Other ways to tell, does your enter key look like this? If your enter key doesn't look like this and looks like a little, like a chicken nugget, then you got an ISO layout. Hands, honestly, thank you so much for being here today. I think you've made a much better choice than what you would have made if you hadn't. And I'm happy to get another QFR into the world, the QFR-I. I'm happy for you. As an enthusiast, I hope that you'll stick around. You'll come join this channel again soon. And you'll be happy because of the decision you made today. Cool. For those of you who've just joined, don't forget to press like on this video to let other people know that we are actually talking about mechanical keyboards. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That's really great. And I'm going to show you guys how to tune in for tomorrow's live stream. Basically, looks like I peeked out then. Sorry for talking so loud. But I'm just going to show you how to do this. I'm going to show you this just so you guys know how to be here for tomorrow. So here we go. I'm just going to show you now.
Okay, guys, here's how you subscribe and catch all the live streams. First, click subscribe, like you normally would. Then click the gear beside it. Now you'll see the notification menu. Click send me all notifications for this channel. That means that next time I start my live stream, you'll get a notification to let you know it's about to start.
Cool, and I'm not going to send out any other channel notifications other than when I'm about to go live stream. So that means more people will be here and more people will know that it's going on. And that'll be cool for you guys and for us. And of course, tomorrow I'm going to be building that 60%. And that'll be fun. Let's split versus diverge. The diverge, I think, is the van. Is that right? I mean, I'm a fan of the Let's Split because I know Max and I think he's really cool. But Francesco, I'm going to stream tomorrow, I think around 3 o'clock. That's my plan anyways.
Eastern Standard.
But again, yeah, that's Eastern Standard Time, New York time. But again, if you do that subscription thing, you'll know when I'm about to start and you'll be able to see. The unique keyboards. I have a unique keyboard that I've never really got working, so... I mean, he seems like a nice enough guy, but I've just never gotten his keyboard working, so... But it's not to say anything against him. I'm trying to remember his name. Not Bernacules. It starts with a B, though. Blalicus. He's a nice dude. He's a really top guy from Unique Keyboards. Personally, I haven't gotten my... I haven't got mine working. Hans, I'm really happy for you. I'm really stoked for you, man. You got a great keyboard today. What's your take on new mechanical membrane keyboards? They're half mechanical keyboards. I've reviewed a couple, and I was kind of like, it's not bad. It's better than I thought it would be, but you know what? It's kind of shitty. Can you show Cherry MX Speed? I don't have any MX Speed, but I'll tell you how they work. So the Cherry MX Speed has the activation of the switch higher up. That's all it is. It's not really that exciting. What do I think of the Ajaz K33 RGB? I actually bought my own Ajaz K33 RGB and I gave it to my mother-in-law. It's a really nice keyboard. She uses it all the time. And I was like, oh, I'm worried about the keycaps rubbing loose or whatever. We saw her after a year. They looked fine. I'm going to go see her again. I'm going to go see her again soon. And it'll be another 6 months on. I bet you they look fine still. Right now for me, the QFRi costs the same as the CM Master Keys Pro S, which is better. Is Mechanisk still here? He would know the answer to that. I don't know what the Master Keys Pro S is. So I'm not really the right person to answer it. Right, I'm going to look it up. Like, give me 1 second. Master Keys Pro S. The Pro S has a standard bottom row. I think that the Pro S is RGB, whereas the Minus I is not. But neither of them will be upgradable with the Frosty Flake, so you choose between them. Can you showcase a keyboard with Cherry MX Blacks? You're looking at it. This is Cherry MX Blacks right here. Shall I show you? It's amazing when somebody asks exactly what you're doing. Look, here's the letter K. Cherry MX Blacks, look at that. Razer Black Widow X Chroma. I don't have any Razer keyboards. There you go, Cherry MX Black. Cherry Reds and Browns. It's a bit difficult to give the sound comparison, but the truth is you won't hear any difference except for the body of the keyboard. Sure. Here's 1 second. I mean, again, it's like it's not a controlled test, but these are PBT keycaps on Cherry MX Reds. You ready? Here we go. That's reds. This is browns. You ready? This is a PBT, but open body keyboard. These are Gaterons. What do you think of that? Okay. Opinions on the Moto Speed Inflector $50 mechanical keyboard. No, don't know anything about it. If you don't like blues, do you think I will? If I don't like blues, do you think I'll like browns? You just think it's time for a change from reds. What is it that you'd? What is it about reds that you wish was a little bit different? Cromoli, what is it that you're looking for? People are asking about Romer G switches. I don't know the answer. Cyrillic official. I don't have an opinion on the Moto Speed Inflector, because I haven't personally tested it, so it's impossible for me to say. Type on the Cherry MX Blacks. Sure. Steph, can you bring those back? Can you compare Cherry MX Black to blue? Yeah, blacks are a stiff, linear. Blues are a tactile, clicky. Typing on the blacks is going to be very similar to red. I mean, there's no real difference except that the spring is stronger. Yep. Are Utemi blue keys good? You know, actually, I thought Utemi blues are actually kind of okay. They're the only, like, I really like cherries. Cherries are good. Gaterons are, believe it or not, better. And then Utemi Blues are the only other one that I think is like in that world. Everything else is like not as good. Kyle's aren't as good. I tried a G switch that wasn't very good. I've tried other things, but Utemi Blues, man, they're kind of not bad. They're kind of pretty good. Steph's phone is ringing, which tells us, which is your favorite switch for gaming? Black. The stiffer the spring, the faster the rebound, more APMs. Would an E element be worth it at only $45? Up to you. If you're going to spend $45, though, why don't you just buy the QFR Rapid I, the Quickfire Rapid? Why don't you just buy this one instead? That's what I'm saying. Doorbell. Are Cherry MX Blacks any good? Yeah, they're right here. These are Cherry MX Blacks. I mean, this is a gaming keyboard. These are both gaming keyboards, really. I mean, what's a Cherry mechanical keyboard if not a gaming keyboard? It'll let you hammer the same switch 50 million times. A mere viewer account asks the most beautiful question of the day. What camera setup are you using for this live stream? Thank you. Let's talk about my streaming setup just for a second. You ready? So this is my overhead. Then we've got my action cam. Oh, wait. Why didn't my action cam work? 1 second. So we got overhead. Then we got action cam. Then we've got my selfie cam. Yo, what's going on, dudes? Then I've got back to my overhead. And I've also got this, which is the best camera of all, my solder cam. Tomorrow I'm going to be using this thing like crazy. Solder cam. Boom, boom. Back to overhead. Those are the cameras that I've got rocking right now. It's not to say I'm not going to have more cameras in the future. I'm just saying those are the ones that I'm rocking right now. Hey, excuse Pete. Are Cherry MX Browns good for gaming and typing? Yes. What are my opinion on MX Browns? They're my least favorite of the MX switches. The reason that browns are my least favorite is that they're not tactile enough. I like a bigger bump, so that's why. What is the black keyboard on the left? This is called the LJD 61 Up. It's from oneupkeyboards.com. It comes as a kit, and if you subscribe and come back tomorrow, I'm actually going to build one in carbon fiber, red carbon fiber, and I'll show you exactly all the steps to go through and do that. Have you ever been using Utemi switches? Yeah, I have Utemi Blues, and I gave them to my mother-in-law recently, and she likes them very much. I think they're a very good switch. You need a dedicated close-up cam. This one's not good enough. This isn't close enough. Is this not close enough for you? Or are you saying you wish that this was close-up all the time? What? What is the reason for the inverted space bar? Yes. You ready for this? This is one of my favorite things to show off. Okay, go to the action cam, and I turn this side. Oh, I can't because I got too many keyboards in the way. Oh, look at this. I put my thing like this. So now you're looking down it, and you can see that I'm going to type like this. But you see the angle that my thumb is at? You see what I'm saying? You see my thumb is at an angle? You see what I'm saying? Do you see what I'm saying here? Look, if it was like this, then my thumb wouldn't be at the same, but look. See what I'm saying? Look at the angle my thumb is at. Okay. Okay, guys, I gotta go for 2 seconds here. I gotta put some of these keyboards away. Just 2 seconds, I'll be right back, I promise. Okay, I'm putting the Philco Magistouch away. This is a Philco Magistouch 2. This is the white top. You can get this at mechanicalkeyboards.com. This has the Triumph Adler keycap set on it. You can't get this anywhere. Sorry, that sucks for you. It's a great keyboard. I would say, in this current configuration, $400. Oh, and it lives in this beautiful black sleeve from oneupkeyboards.com. Look at this. Beautiful. Okay, so that's $450, this one. This one, the LJD 61 Up, fully programmable, 60%. This has the JTK white on black wobs. This is the wob. With the GH60 full carbon fiber, from OneUp Keyboards, it's got the gone feet. I think this rings in around, with these keycaps, around 400, 375, something like that. It's a nice, solid keyboard. Tomorrow I'm going to build one like this on the screen. This is the Cooler Master Quickfire XT. This has PBT, thick PBT, side-printed keycaps on it. And a little cherry thing up in the corner. This is red switches. This does not yet have a programmable. The programmable thing goes over here. This is not yet programmable. I haven't done that to this board yet. In its current configuration, I think this would rock you $120. This also has a beautiful sleeve. I just don't know. I don't know where it is. Cool. Okay. This is OneUp Keyboards, where I recommend, well, I'm part owner of this store. I am the owner of the store. I'm the guy. Basically, I'm the dude. Weekend Airsoft Warrior. Those are actually, these are meant to be the same side prints. They're a little bit different, but they're meant to be the same. These are both from the same company. These are NPKC side printed keycaps. And they are different, but they're the same company and they're meant to be the same. So I don't actually know if you can still get these side printed keycaps. I got these ones on Mass Drop. Corsair K65 or Rapid Fire? Rapid Fire. I'm going to have to just write a little section in the about section that always just says rapid.
You add it to the...
No. Two more questions if I may ask. On Amazon, I find the Cooler Master Storm Rapid Eye Gaming Keyboard MX Red. Is that the right one? And Quickfire XT or Rapid Eye? XT has the number pad. Rapid Eye... Rapid is the TKL, which doesn't have the number pad. XT has the number pad. It's up to you. I mean, I don't mind. You can have whichever one you want. Some gamers prefer the TKLs because it means they can put their mouse here, so it's closer, so you don't have to reach as far. Other people don't mind. Completely up to you. I very rarely use a number pad, and when I do, I reach for a standalone number pad. Just so you know. I love your desk. Is it DIY or bought? This is a purchased stainless steel countertop that I bought from a thrift store. When I was looking for keyboards, I found this 30-inch, it's only 30 inches, 30-inch stainless steel desktop. It was $12. I shortened the leg, one leg, because whoever assembled it was an idiot. I shortened one of the legs, made it work, and then do it. Can I, Hendo E asks, can you build a board with Holtities? I don't even know what those are. Switches on the number pad are Gattasuttles. These will be available on 1UP keyboards in a week or two. They're a very expensive switch. I'm not going to lie to you. They're Gateron switches where you open it up and take the slider from another switch and put them inside. So you got to pay for two switches and the labor of a guy to swap them over. So they're very expensive. They're like, what are they, $2 a switch? The Gattasuttles. I think they are $2 a switch.
Oh, I don't
remember. $1.50 a piece. Pit Fermi asked, did you go to university? If yes, what did you study? Yes, I went to university. I went to Carleton University in Ottawa, Canada. I studied political science and history. And then I moved to the UK and I did a postgrad in advertising. That's my day job, by the way. I am a creative advertiser. I'm a creative director. Are the hot swappable sockets for MX switches? I'd love to, Hendo E. I'd love to. That is something I would love to do. Mist Wickster. Yeah, it's awesome that I got it for $12, but I got it at a thrift store. And the thing with thrift stores is sometimes you can find old mechanical keyboards there. And that's why I go there. And, you know, go see what you can find at those places. Sometimes you can find a real bargain. That's the truth. And, you know, it was $12 plus tax. And the tax, I think it was 94 cents. So maybe it was almost $13. Let me tell you, when she said, oh, no, it's not $12. It's actually closer to $13. Because I'd pull that cash. It was okay. Do you live in the UK? No, I used to live in the UK. I used to live in Loughborough, then Leicester, then Falmouth, then London. But I no longer live there. I now live in New York City. What camera do I use for the overhead? I use the Sony HDR SR11. Pit Fermi, my dad is an engineer, my father-in-law is an electrical engineer, and I'm fascinated by keyboards. I'm also fascinated by all things electronic, and actually if you watch my channel, you'll see a lot of electronic stuff come up in there, but the truth is I'm colorblind, so I struggle a little bit with different resistors, and so I never like got into it properly. It's always just been a hobby of mine. Tom Finley asked, where did I do my postgrad? I did it in Falmouth in Cornwall in the UK. Yeah, we're learning about mechanical keyboards, different types of keyboards, different types of switches. This is Cherry MX Red. These are something called Gattastoggle, which is a merge between different types of switches. Do you use slanted case for the sculpted SAs? That's a great question, and I don't really have an answer because I have Pulse right here, which is a sculpted SA, and I haven't put it on a keyboard yet. The keyboard that I do have SAs on, they're the ice caps, and they're all row threes. Where's your Poker 3 RGB? I gave it away on the channel. Do you guys not remember? Of course you remember. I have to go wash my hands, guys. I'll be right back. Okay, for those of you guys who are new to the channel, things are about to get really, really weird. It's really weird, and here's how it happened. I started doing live streams for the mechanical keyboard community, and one of the members of the community decided that he wanted to buy me pizza. Because I live in New York, and we were talking about New York pizza, now it's kind of become a thing that when I do streams on Saturday evenings across dinner time, that I've started to eat pizza. This isn't pizza. This is a bread roll with some oil, but it comes with a pizza. My God. So for those of you who are new, you're going to be like, this is weird. He's talking about mechanical keyboards and he's eating near one. Yeah, I know. I got to get rid of these things. I got to. Mm.
Preview.
That is a New York style pizza from Patsy's. I know. It gets super weird. No, it's not dollar a slice. This place is one of the places that doesn't do dollar slices.
But we have one of those, which is awesome.
We do have one of those, and it is awesome. But we're coming towards the end of the stream here, guys, so I'm going to keep eating my bread roll and answering any questions. No, you don't want any bread inside the keyboard. Tiago Fire. Yes. I know about those, but I actually have two types of color blindness. I have a mixture of, you got to give me a second. I've got deuteranomaly and protanopia, and the combination, it makes it unlikely that those will work for me. 1990, Sunbird 1990, what's going on? You've just arrived in time for the pizza section. I'm just tearing through some bread roll here. For those of you guys who are new to the channel, you got to be like, what the? But it started as, it's like a meme now. It's almost. Iqbal S, best 60% mech board in your opinion? 1UpKeyboards.com's LJD61 Up. No doubt. Man, this bread is good. Here, action cam. Oh, it's terrible when that happens. Mechanisk, what's going on? We've hit the pizza portion of the evening. All we need is Brotaku and we got a full house. Yeah.
Was your real name Pete?
My real name is Pete. My real name's Pete. I used to be a ski instructor, and I got this great, back in the day, it doesn't work anymore, but I got this great email address, skiwithpete@yahoo.com. It was memorable because it was like, ski with Pete, Yahoo! But then Yahoo Mail started sucking, and so, What's my opinion on Ducky Year of the Monkey? What I can say is I'm a big fan of Ducky. They make quality keyboards. Yeah, a Vipple olive oil. I know. Mmm. Delicious. For those of you who just tuned in, we're coming to the end of the stream, and I'm at the portion where I've started to eat the pizza. It's kind of a meme thing we do in this channel. It's kind of weird, but... Cody, it's a weird time for you to... It's a weird time for you to show up, man. Yeah, it's olive oil and bread. We've been talking about mechanical keyboards, but we've been doing it for so long that it's time to... I gotta eat something. So this, it's so good, it's taking away my breath.
Why do you sell the Zelios with a pack of 45 for 40% plank and other linear feeds use 47%?
I know, we got to go around. I think you should buy a 65 set in that case. We just did a 45 because of JD40 we sell on our website. That takes 40 keys. Does 1UP Keyboard ship to South America? It does. Email us. We'll tell you all about it. I'm so sorry to you guys. Like, I'm looking at the channel. There's still 158 people here. We're winding down. Things are coming to an end soon. We've been talking about keyboards for a long time. Tomorrow, I'm going to build one. In fact, I'm going to press my subscribe button and make you guys watch that video again, just so tomorrow you guys know what's happening and when it's happening.
Okay, guys. Here's how you subscribe and catch all the live streams. First, click subscribe, like you normally would. Then click the gear beside it. Now you'll see the notification menu. Click send me all notifications for this channel. That means that next time I start my live stream, you'll get a notification to let you know it's about to start.
Somebody said, can you show us your setup? You're saying which keyboard I use. Is there any possibility to ship keyboard to Poland? Yeah, of course. Just email us and then tell us what keyboard you want and we'll hook you up. What switches do you recommend installing on bread? Or do you stick with the brown switches that come with it? I say brown bread is, you know, better. Black bread is not as good. Blue bread is definitely a void. You know, that's this plate. I know 1990 Sunbird 1990 was asking earlier. This is an IKEA original plate. I think it's 120 gram. Bread gam. Bread gam. Delicious. The actuation on this bread is very good. Again, I know some of you guys are new. Pitt says, how old are you and is the lady your wife? The lady is my wife and I'm 39. Do you add salt to the bread? No, I don't. It's a cool way to end a stream, I think, but at the same time, my numbers are diving so heavily that I wonder if people are like, oh my God, what is going on here? The best white gaming board in your opinion? That's a good question. I don't really know. There aren't that many white boards. There's only really the Poker 3 that I know that's white. The Ajaz has a white bottom but a silver top. I'm not really sure, to be honest. Rafo, yeah, sorry, you guys are new, you just turned up and you're like, what? You're like, what the hell is going on here? Yeah, I know. Red bread, yeah, red bread, I mean, it sounds good. I'm new and I see this shit, I know. Guys, we're coming to the end of the stream, I've been streaming for like hours now. I've been streaming since like 5 o'clock or something. I'm just eating. We're coming to the end of the stream. So here's the long version. For those of you who just tuned in, here's how we go again. I live in New York City. One of the guys from the community saw that I was in New York City and wanted to buy me a pizza and have it sent to my place so that I would eat it on camera. Now, yes. That's what I'm doing. What am I using to record? OBS. What do I think about the Cherry MX Board 6? Expensive, but very cool. Could I put LEDs in the QFR if I broke it down? No. There's no holes for it. But if you bought the Phantom, I think you could. best thrift store in New York City. There's no best thrift store. Just go to them all. You got to go to them all the time because they're always changing over everything. What do you record with? That's why I said OBS. Have you heard about the Tada 68? I have a Tada 68. You can check out my channel. Do a quick search for the Tada 68. Ski with Pete. You'll totally find it. Am I going to waste the oil? Yeah, this oil is going to be, it's kind of going to be wasted. But the truth is, I'm probably going to dip my pizza crust in it too. Dude, why are you eating in the live stream? Dude, I can't explain it any more than it's a thing that's, it used to be that my numbers would go up when I was eating. Now, things have changed. Things have changed. It's all different now. Who makes keycaps for the K65 non-backlit? That's a good question, and there is no answer. The K65 has a really unusual size space bar, and so there's no straight-up answer to that. Man, that bread was good. Delicious. I know, it's like, what do you want? Do you want me to stream or do you want me to eat? Like, you know, you want me to do both? Well, I'll do both then. Fine, you know. You don't want me to eat? Fine. I can't not eat.
What's a phantom?
What is a phantom? I happen to have one just around the corner here. Give me one sec. This is the Phantom. This is a replaceable. This is a drop-in. No. This is a custom PCB made by a guy named Epiphany that sold on mechanicalkeyboards.com. And the Phantom is the right size and has the right everything to be dropped into the QFR. So if you desolder your board from the QFR, put this in, put your Teensy back here, then you can turn your QFR into a fully programmable keyboard. And, oh no, damn it. There's no LED holes on here. Dude, I take it back. Pixel GF, my camera, this camera? No, this is a Sony HDR SR11. Where did I get the pizza? Patsy's. So no LEDs. Eat the pizza now, I beg you. See what I'm saying? Things change, guys. A minute ago, people were complaining about me eating the bread. I got the bread from the pizza place. It's the best bread. Is this the weird side about YouTube I keep hearing about? Yes, this is the weird side of YouTube. It's going to get weirder because I'm going to eat salad before I get to the pizza. Guys, I'm telling you, it's crazy stuff happening here. Like, what? And yet, people, you're going to be like, what? And you're going to tell people that you were watching a guy eat pizza on a live stream and like, what? Face cam, please. Oh, Steph says no. I don't care. I did it anyways. So the weird thing with the face cam is I got to look there to look you guys in the eye, but I can't do that if I look at me on the screen or you in the comments. So I'm kind of like doing this all the time, but Poker 3 is great. Yeah, Poker 3 is a solid pickup for anybody. Absolutely. Where can I get good keycaps for backlit keyboard? I recommend mechanicalkeyboards.com. The PBT plus POM, PBT plus POM, people call it, is very good. Which CM Storm is better, the Master Key or the Rapid? If you get the Rapid, you can upgrade it. People are begging for the pizza, Steph. I gotta eat salad, guys. You gotta be healthy first. The Rapid you can upgrade with the Frosty Flake and make it fully programmable. The Master Key is an RGB keyboard and you can't upgrade it. But you get the RGB. Are you guys really sure you want to watch me eat salad and pizza? Because otherwise I could just cut the stream down. Have you gotten one-shot modifiers to work on the QMK? I haven't. Dude, what? I have not got one-shot modifiers to work in QMK. I haven't tried it, but I know that people do it and use it and they love it. Trying to read. Hey, Mechanisk is back. Sup. Yep, salad. Salad is happening.
No, you're doing pizza and salad.
I'm doing pizza and salad, guys. You can't discriminate on a plate. Look, you gotta understand, I'm here entertaining you guys. Steph is hooking me up with a pizza. Ready for the Vortex Core? I am ready for it. I keep asking them to send me one, and they just refuse to do it. I think that they know that I eat too much pizza on my live streams. So they're just not that down with it. But no, I've talked to them about it, and I've asked them to send one. My favorite customs key set. You know what? The Modern Selectric All Black is the one that I don't own that I'm most jealous of. But Eve is the nicest one that I do own in DSA. In Cherry Profile Stormtrooper, which I just got. I'm super excited. And... what else? What do I think about the CM Quickfire TK Red switches? Again, it's a great keyboard. Like, I'm not insulting the keyboard. I'm just saying one of the things about the Quickfire TK is it has a non-standard bottom row, and so that's going to be difficult for you in the future.
If you
want to
change keycaps.
If you want to change keycaps in the future.
If you're happy with the keycaps.
All right then. What type of salad is this, Steph?
Siciliana
salad with shredded carrots, olives, and that's an artichoke heart over there. Right there. That pizza, can't wait to get to that. Should you get the RGB red versus the Storm Rapid Eye? Makes no difference. Makes no difference. Are you at your house? I am at my house.
Apartment.
And actually, I rent it. I'm a 39-year-old renter. Swag852, yes. So now that I'm eating pizza and hanging out with you guys, what do you guys think about the Casey Neistat thing? No, I mean, I'm interested in it because, I mean, he's a fellow New Yorker and he's just quit YouTube. Well, he hasn't quit, but... Zambumon, I'm not an artisan guy, personally. Steph is into... Steph is doing the artisan thing. When are you going to do a face cam? Here's my face cam. What the hell? It's not that big a deal, is it? Does the pizza smell good? Yeah, it smells good. Are you advertising your keyboards? In a sense, I'm more of an enthusiast for the community rather than just a shill for 1UP keyboards, but... 1UP Keyboards does have some pretty damn good keyboards. I say that because I wanted to sell the best ones.
Sellout. Or Casey question.
Liberal sellout. Sellout. Wow. Caveman, nice guy. Love it. I see CM Storm XT on the desk. With PBT side printed keycaps. Little Beast, yeah, don't worry about it. Jordan, it's nice of you to say. This is all fake. This is not... Little Beast, you're totally right. I'm not actually eating this salad. This... I'm actually... What you can't see is I'm just scraping it into the rubbish bin behind me. I mean, why would I... Why would I eat salad for real on my channel? That's crazy. I'm faking my mouth being full. The stream has turned awkward. Oh. Okay, well, I'm going to take one bite of pizza and then I'm going to end this thing. What kind of keyboard do I recommend? The QFR Cooler Master Quick Fire Rapid is the one I recommend for beginners. If you're not a beginner, buy the 1UP Keyboards LJD 61UP. Does double shot mean they're backlit? No! Can I show you what it means? Let me show you. Here we go. I got a 1UP keycap here. Double shot means that they use plastic twice. They first inject white plastic and then inject black plastic in this case. So you get this white legend. You don't have to do that. There's other ways of printing on keycaps that aren't double shot. Double shot is the better quality way of doing it. Cool. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Looking forward to tomorrow's stream. That's going to be a lot of fun. I'm just going to take one bite of pizza just to keep the meme going, and then I'm going to disappear. Thank you very much, guys, for tuning in today. Don't forget to press subscribe, like. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to, I don't know, do whatever else we're supposed to do with these videos.
And tomorrow,
I'll see you guys tomorrow around 3 p.m. Do the subscribe thing. I'm going to put it up one more time. Do the subscribe thing and make sure you get notification when the video is happening. Damn, why isn't it happening? Subscribe there.
Okay, guys, here's how you subscribe and catch all the live streams. First, click subscribe, like you normally would, then click the gear beside it. Now you'll see the notification menu. Click send me all notifications for this channel. That means that next time I start my live stream, you'll get a notification to let you know it's about to start.
I had my first bite, I'm sorry. I couldn't wait. You guys were doing the subscribe thing. Thank you again, guys. Thank you, everybody who tuned in. New York City time zone. So around 3. I'm going to have to stick to 3. Too many people know about it. If I'm lucky, we'll start a little early. If I'm unlucky, we'll start a little late. So thank you very much for everybody for tuning in. Thank you so much to everybody who's visited the site and made purchases today at 1UpKeyboards.com. But beyond that, support the community. Don't forget to go out there, check out new keyboards, ask questions, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys tomorrow for tomorrow's build. That'll be a lot of fun, and there's going to be some giveaways. There's going to be a lot of giveaways, actually. It's going to be a lot of fun. Can't wait to see you then. Thanks again, guys. Thank you to Mechanisk and the other mods, Weekend Airsoft Warrior, and everybody else. Really appreciate you guys helping out. It's been awesome. See you guys again tomorrow. Don't forget, you can hang around. Even though I turn the channel off, the stream will be over, but the chat continues. You guys can keep asking each other questions about mechanical keyboards. Keep the conversation going. Thanks again to everybody who's tuned in today. It's been awesome. Thank you, guys. See you tomorrow.